this video, we're going to show how to perform a slump test for a patient. You're going to have the patient sitting on the edge of a table or surface. Chair works as well. I like to sit on a stool because then I can be in a good body position, and I'll kind of move throughout the video. So I'll show you how this works. So the first thing I'm going to ask her to do is you place your hands behind you. And this just standardizes the test. This is how the test has been described. Next thing I'm going to have you do, Grace, is just slouch forward as if I were to kind of punch you in the stomach. Any symptoms with that? And then you tuck your chin towards your chest. Good. I'm going to place my hand on her head, my forearm across her back. I'm not creating much pressure here, but I'm just trying to maintain this position as we get into greater tension through the lower body. Next thing I'm going to ask you to do is just straighten out that leg, and I'm going to kind of help her with this motion, kind of block. No symptoms there. Okay, so we create full knee extension. Last thing I'm going to do is just add that dorsal flexion. Any symptoms with that?
Maybe a little.
Okay, and then I'm going to bring her out of that. Does that make it better or worse?
Better.
Better? Okay, so we're working with a little bit more tension, taking tension off, she's better. So some structural differentiation towards the end of that test. I can also let her head come up a little bit. Does that make it better or worse?
Better.
Better. Okay, great. So that is the slump test.